What a computer is to me is it's the most remarkable tool that we've ever come up with. And it's the equivalent of a bicycle for our minds.
We are delivering today
the iPad,
the new iMac, the iPod, iPhoto, MacBook Air, iTunes. It's a revolutionary moment.
Down at his running shoes, and then he looked up at me and he said, "Do you want to sell sugar water for the rest of your life? Or do you want to come with me and change the world?"
This is their consumer notebook, and it looks like this, and you just sort of see it's about that thick, and it's got some nice fans in the back, so you can keep an eye on them. And let me show you the new iBook. Is the new iBook 1.3 inches thick? There it is. I don't think it could be more black and white. Look at the remote controls from Microsoft's Media Center. This is one from Gateway and one from HP. This is what they look like. This is what it takes to operate that sort of thing. And this is ours. And if you just count the buttons, theirs are over 40 and ours are 6. So I don't know that there's ever been a slide that captures what Apple's about as much as this one. Look at this. And we think there's a much better way. We think the much better way is that. So far ahead of anybody, it's not done. We just introduced our third generation iPod. Our competitors haven't even caught up with our first generation yet. We're in our third. Our competitors haven't even caught up with what we introduced 2 years ago. I don't know what they're going to do about this. What's wrong with their user interfaces? Well, the problem with them is really sort of in the bottom 40 there. It's this stuff right here. They all have these keyboards that are there whether you need them or not to be there. And they all have these control buttons that are fixed in plastic and are the same for every application. Well, every application wants a slightly different user interface, a slightly optimized set of buttons just for it. And what happens if you think of a great idea 6 months from now? You can't run around and add a button to these things. They're already shipped. So what do? It doesn't work because the buttons and the controls can't change. Starbucks. I'm going to search for Starbucks, and sure enough, there's all the Starbucks. And I can even go look at that Starbucks, and there it is, and let's give them a call.
Good morning, Starbucks. How can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to order 4,000 lattes to go, please. No, just kidding. Wrong number. Thank you. Bye-bye. But I have to tell you, there's some stuff in our industry that we wouldn't be proud to ship, that we wouldn't be proud to recommend to our family and friends. And we can't do it. We just can't ship junk. An iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod, a phone. Are you getting it? These are not three separate devices. This is one device. And we are calling it iPhone. Today, Apple is going to reinvent the phone. And here it is. Oh, a stylus, right? We're going to use a stylus. No. No. Who wants a stylus? You have to get them and put them away and you lose them. Yuck. Nobody wants a stylus. So let's not use a stylus. We're going to use the best pointing device in the world. We're going to use a pointing device that we're all born with. We're born with 10 of them. We're going to use our fingers. We're going to touch this with our fingers. And we have invented a new technology called multi-touch, which is, you can do multi-finger gestures on it. And boy, have we patented it. So,
$500, fully subsidized with a plan? I said, that is the most expensive phone in the world, and it doesn't appeal to business customers because it doesn't have a keyboard, which makes it not a very good email machine. What's big phones? Right now, we're selling millions and millions and millions of phones a year. Apple is selling zero phones a year. 6 months, they'll have the most expensive phone by far ever in the marketplace, and let's see. Let's see how the competition goes.
Do we get a free Wi-Fi or something like that?
Well, see, I'm a simpleton. I've always had this view that we pay taxes and the city should do those things. That's why we pay taxes. Now, if we can get out of paying taxes, I'll be glad to put up Wi-Fi.
We were just the lucky partnership. He was lucky to have me in the beginning, but I am much, incredibly lucky to him for everything in my life. He gets a reputation for being a strong leader and being brash, but to me, he was just always so kind, such a good friend, and I'm just going to miss him.
All right, Steve Wozniak, co-founder of Apple. Thank you very much. Well said. Thank you. Yeah, I really appreciate you talking to us. I know.